You know that Red Sox shirt that fit you in high school, but not now? Don't throw it away. We'll tell you about a better use for it in a few minutes. But first, ready to eat the West Coast way?
The cuisine, Mexican coastal.
I traveled to Mexico a ton of times and just fell in love with the country. And I just wanted to bring a little piece of that back to Boston.
The decor, Baja breezy.
I wanted this place to be light, airy, sort of beachy.
The vibe?
We certainly don't take ourselves too seriously here.
Boston's Back Bay welcomes Citrus and Salt, the newest creation from local restaurateur, chef, and season 7 Hell's Kitchen finalist, Jason Santos, who's also behind restaurants Buttermilk and Bourbon and Abbey Lane.
I'm pretty convinced that I came out of the womb making aioli. I've been cooking my whole entire life. I've worked for some amazing chefs in Boston, which has thus brought me to this spot.
Here, everyone gets to share small plates, all recipes created by Santos.
So these are all my favorite items on this menu. So this is the fresh crab tostada, avocado, crispy leeks on top. This is the amazing street corn crushed with flaming hot Cheetos. And this is the duck flautas, which is sort of a fried taco. And these are chilaquiles, my version of nachos, some goat cheese, fundido, fresh green onions on top, scallion, and some shaved onion.
But the number one seller, the guacamole, served with house-made jalapeno and cheese-flavored kettle chips.
All right, so why a kettle chip versus the tortilla chip?
Because everybody does a tortilla chip, and I have blue hair, and I need to stand out, so we do potato chips.
Is there a secret ingredient?
If it was secret, I couldn't tell you. I can't answer that. So the secret ingredient is avocados. How about that?
Clever.
Also clever, the assortment of creative cocktails.
My favorite drink is tequila in tears. It's agave, egg whites, it's shaken, and it has this cool little tattoo on top. Super original and really fun. Another drink on the menu that everybody loves, it's called Take Your Pants Down. So the method behind that is you have a drink and then you take your pants down. I'm just kidding. So it's a really cool drink. It's got pink grapefruit juice, a salted rim, tons of different boozes in it. It's a really just sort of fun, whimsical take on, you know, tequila and a margarita.
Also whimsical, painted flowers on the floor, turquoise wicker chairs, and a skeleton mural behind the bar. Santos says he wants to give Citrus and Salt patrons a memorable experience.
I think gone are the days where people come and just have food and drink and go home. I think it's important that there's, you know, it's Instagrammable, there's pictures to be taken, it's exciting. You know, I just want people to leave and be like, wow, that was a really great experience.
Admit it. Who doesn't have a stash of old t-shirts they no longer wear and can't bear to part with? Project Repat turns t-shirts into comfy quilts. Now, the once-only online business has a store where customers can create their own quilts.
Erin, I brought a pile of my favorite t-shirts.
Great.
A lot of them have some sentimental value.
Erin Kaiser is director of retail. Ross Lohr and Nathan Rothstein are
CEO, president.
Yes, but I'm president of blankets.
One thing we really wanted to find out is whether there are a lot of customers out there who maybe are afraid to just buy online and ship something through the mail to one of our production facilities. And so having this store allows us to create trust in the community. We've made 200,000 of these just online, but we think this is going to take us to the next level.
The quilts are made in factories in Fall River and North Carolina. Rothstein and Lohr are not only saving t-shirts from landfills, they've created jobs.
There's about 70 people who are making these every single day. These were places that once had a thriving textile industry, and through upcycling people's t-shirts, we're able to bring back textile jobs.
We say we're repatriating textile jobs back to the United States.
And that's why they named the company Project Repat. Here's how it works.
This first one was a t-shirt that my husband wore when both of my children were born.
Step one, get over the separation anxiety.
I'm a Vineyard girl.
Classic.
Yep, we can't forget about the Red Sox. My daughter loved this shirt. My pets, my son's favorite shirt. He lost his first tooth in this shirt.
So after we cut the panels out and sew them together, we'll pick out some polar fleece for you. We'll put that right in the back, so it makes a really nice, cozy product for you.
So how many t-shirts do you need to make a quilt?
Our smallest size is a lap size. You can do that with as few as 8 t-shirts, front and back, all the way up to a king size quilt, which is 64 panels. Could really just encompass entire life story of t-shirts.
Now the fun part, getting creative.
Okay, I think that looks pretty good. I'm happy with the colors. Yeah. I'm happy with the story. I'm still nervous, I'm not gonna lie.
We're gonna take really good care of your shirts.
So when you started in 2012, did you think you'd be where you are now?
To be honest with you, I never thought I would make a living selling t-shirt quilts. But knowing that we're creating a product that's 100% recycled and we're paying people well, it feels really good.
And here it is. I absolutely like it. Love it. I don't like it. I love it. It is like wearing the story of my life. Look at this. All of my memories recycled. And you should know you do not need to book an appointment online before heading to Repat's Newtonville store. But what a great way to preserve all of your favorite memories. Next, a question for the superstar cast of Black Panther.
Have you understood what kind of cultural phenomena is being created